Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Richmond Spiders and the Providence Friars.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Friars should be in for an easy one tonight, Dick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. First, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Second of all, make good decisions with the rock. Don't turn it over, baby. And lastly, you got to pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Got a man in high post. Gave it up. He goes for three. Off the mark. Controlling the ball. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again.
Look at that spacing.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble. Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure. Check that basketball with that good defensive rebound. As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. They work it around the perimeter.
Try to go inside.
The shooting guard in the paint.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Crockett handles the pass. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Receives the ball for the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Hamilton handles the feed. Just too slow to stay with his man, Dick, and he picks up the foul.
Well, two mistakes. Number one, he lets him get the ball in that deep. And number two, he doesn't have any footwork and doesn't move and beat him to the spot.
Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Looks at a three. Off the rim and no good. Clifton receives the pass.
No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. With a deep shot from outside. He buries the shot.
We'll get a better look on the replay.
Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
From the top of the circle, Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to dive the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
They're working around the arc. For two, goes. Shoots from outside. Way off target. Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
Brad, if they were smart, they'd go 2-for-1.
Top of the circle. Makes it.
That one's definitely worth a second look, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Trying to draw the foul.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Shot clock is dead.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. From downtown.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
And the ball goes out of play. He puts it up there. Off the rim and no good. At the half, the Spiders are trailing by 6. Is making good use of the three ball here, Dick.
Absolutely, Brad. So far, at least 50% of their scoring output comes from behind the arc. When you're burying them from the three like that, you can second-guess the defense by taking the ball to the hole.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. There's the pick. There's the roll. Kept alive. They're getting no good looks at the hoop tonight, Dick.
I don't know what they're doing, but they're squandering away. All those easy looks underneath.
Goes up for two. In and out.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Top, controlling the ball for two, and in and out. And a momentary look from three-point land.
That was a high post screen, close to the lane.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
On the outside, The shooting guard takes the feed and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. The offense is having a hard time finding the open look.
Great defense. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot. Set that screen away.
On the dribble, gives it up. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
They look to get it to the inside. The ball goes out of bounds. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
The Friars have got a couple NIT championships and Final Four appearances. Not to mention a collection of outstanding past players and past players turned coaches, Dick.
Well, the Friars have had some great on the sidelines and suiting up for them. It's rare that you see a school like this with few national championship banners. Look at that spacing.
Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Way off target.
No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He lets it fly.
He can't get the Jay to go despite running off the nice screen.
This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
Timeout. They want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. Dick, 6-point lead here.
They have to keep applying the pressure if they want to win this one, Brad.
Let's it fly. Off the rim and no good. The point guard takes the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And again, they look to run. Tries for two. They're just having a devil of a time getting good looks at the hole.
That's right, Brad. I haven't seen a whole lot of plays carried out and executed the way they should be.
Trying to feed inside. Theodore handles the feed. Gave it up. They've left him completely alone. Dumps it in. Theodore receives the ball. I gotta be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Kelly is emotionally fired up.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you should be afraid to show your emotions.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Brad, I think he'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again. At the line. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Sinks it. Time to talk it over. We got a timeout.
the timeout, Brad.
We're going to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. Rims out. Shot clock is dead. He steps up to the line. Got it. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Makes it. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
He fires from long range. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Friars is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.